slapped away from behind. Ricky goes back to get it. Fires it cross court. Jeff's got it right up into the alley. Power slam! Tomahawk jam!
Oh my god! Starting this video off with a bang! Let's just roll that back. We see Sean Kemp take one dribble and then he ends Alton Lister's life! And then after killing him, he just points at him as if to say, I just dunked on you and you're on the ground and that kinda sucks. I think I can safely say that this video is gonna be fun to make. Now, to give you a little backstory on what's happening with this Sean Kemp dunk, this is game four of a playoff series against the Warriors. Sean Kemp was getting some hard fouls all series, so he takes it out on Alton Lister. Seriously, number one, what kind of name is Alton? And number two, how do you go home to your family after this? I'm pretty sure what happens is you go home to your house and you find it deserted because your wife has left you for Sean Kemp, which would actually make a lot of sense because by the age of 28, Sean Kemp had 7 children with 6 different wives. So that's a little crazy, but the craziest part about this dunk might be what happens next. Somehow, in the same game, we see a Sonics player go up for a layup. Chris Gatling on the Warriors swats it, Sean Kemp grabs it, and then oh my god, again! Sean Kemp seriously had 2 of the most incredible dunks in NBA history in the same game, and Chris Gatling isn't even mad. I mean, I'm sure he's now dead inside, but he tries his best to play it off by just dapping Sean Kemp up, which to be fair is actually pretty smart. I mean, Sean Kemp already stole Alton Lister's wife, Chris Gatling was just playing it safe. So what's up guys, I hope you enjoyed that intro, and I hope you're ready for more savage moments. My name is Mike, and today we are going to be looking at 10 more savage moments. So 12 in total. And before we look at the next 10, I just want to say we are getting very, very close to 1 million. So if you enjoy this content and you want to make the climb to 1 million together, make sure to subscribe so we can hit 1 million, baby. That's just insane. And once we hit 1 million, I'm going to do the biggest giveaway I have ever done. So get hyped. And now let's look at savage moment number 10, Blake Griffin dunking all over Pau Gasol. So we see this is back when Pau Gasol was on the Lakers and Blake Griffin still had full use of both of his legs. RIP monster athlete Blake, you are always going to be missed. But today we get to reminisce a little bit because after a missed shot in the corner, oh my god! Oh! So right away guys, I just want to say, this is why your coach tells you to box out. Pau Gasol's just standing there, he doesn't realize he's about to be murdered, but that's what happens. Blake just jumps completely over him, dunks the ball, and then somehow catches it. Almost forgot, he also stares at Pau Gasol's dead body on the floor as he walks away smiling. Amazing. And he probably won't top it, right? Well, watch this. Oh my god! That was legitimately one of those dunks we used to see in the old 2K where you would just dunk over everyone. But it actually happened. My favorite part about this is that, yeah, Blake did put his forearm into Pau Gasol's head, and Pau Gasol, you know, spent the rest of the game complaining and whining to the refs about it. And Kobe, after the game, was asked why wasn't he complaining, and he just smiled and goes, ugh, because it was a legitimate dunk. So if the Mamba says it was okay on his own teammate, then shut up, Pau Gasol, you just got embarrassed twice. Okay, for number 8, we have a casual LeBron James dunk. Now, the Bulls were actually first in the Eastern Conference this season, and I guess LeBron James wasn't too happy about that, because he chose this possession to jump over John Lucas. He jumped over a grown man on a basketball court for an alley-oop. Why don't we talk about this all the time? John Lucas was basically just a prop in LeBron James' own in-game dunk contest. I mean, we were talking about how Alton Lister goes on before. I mean, props to John Lucas for making it to the NBA being that short, but it seems like the basketball gods awarded him by making him into LeBron James' hurdle. Doesn't seem really fair. All right, number 8, we got some good old-fashioned Dikembe Mutombo trash talk.
Mike, come on, man. Be for real, you haven't got me yet.
Don't even try it. I haven't got you recently. Yeah, I agree with
no,
that.
No, you haven't got me in 6 years.
Dikembe.
No.
Never
mind. He said, I'll get you one day.
So we see Mike was just, you know, kind of soaking that all in, which is why it's no surprise when next season, Michael Jordan, bang! You do not trash talk the GOAT. You just don't do it. Number 7, we're going from Michael Jordan to Yusuf Nurkic. Mostly because we've been looking at a lot of dunks right now. So let's watch this casually savage move. We've got Nurkic backing down Markieff Morris. Markieff Morris flops. Nurkic just kind of hesitates, says, what are you doing? And just lays it in. And then it just hands the ball to Markieff Morris as to say, nice try, buddy. And of course, Nurkic gets a technical foul here, but that's just absurd in my opinion. I mean, he is doing the NBA a service. Markieff Morris just flopped. Nurkic put him in his place. He said, there's no room for floppers. Stop being a I am fully in favor of creating rules to stop flopping. Fines have obviously not worked. Are they even still fining people? Like, what happened to that? So instead of fines, we need to embarrass people. If the NBA actually wants to create a of the day on Twitter, I think that would help. With number six, we've got Paul Pierce. Now, we all know Paul Pierce is about that life. The man was stabbed on September 25th, 2000, and still played all 82 games of the 2001 season. If that's not tough, I don't know what is. He also happens to be an incredible trash talker. As we see here, Paul Pierce and Al Harrington are just talking trash right to each other as Pierce is just running down the clock, just isolating, just not moving, because he knows what he's about to do. Step back three, bang. I mean, if you're gonna trash talk someone while dribbling a basketball and then shooting it, you better make the shot. And Paul Pierce did make the shot, and Al Harrington now has a memory that probably will haunt him for the rest of his life. Funny story, similar thing happened to me once. This was back in high school, and I pulled up from like a deep NBA three and completely airballed. Yes, I considered walking off the court in shame. Let's move on. Okay, so for number five, we're just going with a classic. This was easily the greatest moment in Allen Iverson's career in the greatest game he ever played. Yes, this is Allen Iverson stepping over Tyronn Lue, but I feel like a lot of people do not know the context of what was happening here. This wasn't just a disrespectful moment, because we are in overtime of game one of the 2001 NBA Finals. And in this game, the Sixers were actually down five early in overtime. Then Rajah Bell hit a shot. Allen Iverson made two free throws. Then Allen Iverson made a huge three, and suddenly the Sixers were up two and they had the ball again. So there was only 50 seconds left in the game when Allen Iverson drives, steps back, shoots in Tyronn Lue's face, and drains it. And these were his 48th points of the game, which is no wonder why he was feeling himself and just steps over Tyronn Lue. I mean, if I was Tyronn Lue, I wouldn't be having nightmares of any of my Cavaliers finals losses. I'd be having nightmares of Allen Iverson's shoe almost stepping on my face. And yes, the Sixers did win this game. Iverson actually ended up with 50 points, but the Lakers won the next four. Still though, he stepped over the man. Number four, we've got Russell Westbrook, and this really isn't about the play. Even though this layup that Russ makes was absolutely ridiculous. Nope, it's more about the fact that this guy just starts flipping off Russ in the stands. And Russ is just casually like, who let this guy in the game? What's happening? And this grown man who is a urologist suddenly became a meme. So, you know, all of his friends and patients and colleagues were kind of questioning what he was doing. And he said that Russell Westbrook said, "Sit down, f-ing fat boy," when the guy stood to boo at Westbrook. If that's true, well, I don't really care, because this is just really funny either way. Number three, we've got a throwback Amari moment. Now, you guys heard me go on my tangent about flops before, and it turns out Amari Stoudemire is really the hero that we need. So we're in the NBA playoffs, Knicks versus Heat, the Heat are up 3-1. We see the ball scrambles around a little bit, it ends up in Amari Stoudemire's hands. He tries to take it to the basket, but notorious flopper Shane Battier just suddenly dies on a basketball court. And you know, Shane Battier did this all the time. I'm pretty sure he was one of the most hated players in the NBA at the time for flopping. So we see Amari pretend to holds his hand to help Shane Battier up, and then just like, "Nah, bro," and just walks up the court. Amari, again, you are the hero we need. We need more players shaming flopping. Number two, we are back to Allen Iverson. So we know it's a popular thing that when the whistle blows, players will not let the other team make a basket. Basically, if someone takes a jump shot, some 7-foot monster will just come up and just swat it out of the way, which is exactly what Dwight Howard originally does to Allen Iverson. So AI just throws the ball as high as he possibly can, and it just swishes through the net. I mean, the greatest thing is that Dwight looks at the ball and is like, "Can I get that? Nope." And it just goes right in. And yes, this definitely got bonus points for being casually savage. Just like the last moment on our list involving Kobe Bryant. Also, quick note, this list is not in order. Anyway, I think you guys all knew this was coming. We've got Matt Barnes. We've got Kobe Bryant. They've been getting into almost fights the whole game. They obviously do not like each other right now. Eventually would be teammates, but for right now, things are getting heated. And so Matt Barnes decides he's gonna scare Kobe. He's gonna embarrass him by ball faking right to his face. Only Kobe, the savage that he is, just takes it, just doesn't even react. He just keeps standing there chewing gum and is like, "You serious? I'm Kobe Bryant? You're not gonna get me." And there we have it, guys, the NBA's most savage moments. Now, the NBA has been around for a long time, so I definitely did not cover every savage moment that's ever happened. So if you guys wanna see a part two, comment down below what other savage moments you want to see. And remember, we're on the grind to 1 million. 1 million. million. So make sure to subscribe to be a part of this journey and so that we can get to 1 million subs together. And to everyone who's already subscribed, thank you guys so much. It's just really incredible the amount of support that you guys have shown. Seriously, I do not take it for granted. I am grateful for it every day. And so you're awesome. You know this, and as always, have an awesome day, and cue that music.
I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. You come around, yeah. You ease my mind, you make everything feel fine. Worry about those comments, I'm way too numb, yeah. It's way too dumb, yeah.